a really extraordinary album. This one, A Flourish.
Come on, ghosts.
I'm dead.
I'm
the movie's fun.
Toby, Sebastian.
Together we're
A Flourish.
You're watching Life Talk.
Is being released by a fairly new label, Generation Prog Records, and they were very interested to get their music out, so they sent me a copy of the album. And I gotta say, it wasn't love at first listen, but it is an album that grows. And I gotta say, I found that this is an extraordinary album with amazing music on it. Now, of course, this is not the real cover, because they put it in a nice cardboard package. And this is the real cover. We have the back side. Now, of course, this cover fits the whole idea of Coma Ghosts a little bit more. You know, the bleak image, the skies. You know, it's not a really happy picture. And well, to be honest, it's not really happy music. It's not depressing, but it's dark and it's a bit sad. But it's very good. This young German band brings, well, here I say it again, an extraordinary debut album. The band exists for a couple of years already, but well, finally they come up with, well, good material to present as their calling card, you know, because they want to make a good first impression. And I gotta say, they make an amazing first impression with this album. Before we move on to the music, let's take a look inside. Now, as you can see, there's some really nice artwork alongside the lyrics. And of course, the artwork matches, well, the mood and the atmosphere of the music. Now, there's a lot more artwork, but that's for you to discover. We also have the band members. One more. The rest, you can look for yourself. It's a thick booklet. There's a lot in it. What's also in it is, of course, this, the full band. Now, you can already see it's a female fronted band. So let's, you know, introduce the members to you of A Flourish. Nikki Weber on vocals, Toby Suess on drums, Tim Ivanich on guitars, Dave Mola guitars and keys, Sebastian Ott bass. They had one lineup change shortly after the release of this album. Tim Ivanich, well, sadly left the band. Now, fortunately, the band found a replacement guitar player by the name of Chris. You can check him out on the website. There he is. To start with the guitar players, there are two guitar players and I don't know who's doing what, but there are a lot of really strong, crunchy rhythm guitars on the album and there are absolutely beautiful solos. The rhythm section of this band is rock solid and gives it, you know, a really fantastic body to put on those really heavy songs. Toby and Sebastian, drums and bass, work really well together, really tight. And added to that, the rhythm guitars, absolutely very heavy and good for the songs of this album. Now, as I said, guitar solos, you know, they have this heavy rhythms, that a lot of songs are very rhythmic, but then they just break out in a fantastic guitar solo. And what I like about it is that it's not over the top. It's not just, you know, showing off, but it really feels natural. You really, when you have the flow of the music, you really say, yeah, you expect a guitar solo there, and that is absolutely fantastic. Then we come to the vocal parts, and there's something I absolutely have to mention because it was a bit of a shock to me, and that happened when I was listening to the second track of the album. The second track of the album, Spectre Part 1, Zoria's Dawn, and there I heard a different side from Nikki on vocals. Along the album, She sings in a very, you know, fairly high, very clear voice, very powerful. You know, you often get the generalization that it's gothic metal and like Within Temptation or Nightwish, you know. But this band is totally different from that. They're a progressive metal band. And the progressive part, you know, I will tell you a little bit more later, but it is progressive in the truest sense of the word. And it also shows in the vocals, because yes, she has some high, clear, powerful vocals, but she also has some softer, more gentle, fragile vocals. And she has really dark, aggressive vocals, because she also does grunts in the music. Now, I gotta be honest, I'm not really a big fan of that, when the ladies do the grunting. Nevertheless, when you know, when I listen to the album and the overall sound, I gotta say, you know, the grunts are not in every song, they're not throughout the whole song, but they're just here and there, you know, to give contrast to the songs, emphasize the dark parts in it. And as a whole, I gotta say, I'm still not a fan of it, but you know, at least I can appreciate it. You know, I understand why the band does it, and well, who knows, maybe in time I'll even start to like them. That is something that I noticed in the vocal parts, but as I said, this makes, again, the band progressive. It makes the band stand out. It makes gives the band its own identity. The first three tracks are you know, prog metal. They're heavy, there are a lot of guitars in it, fast drums, heavy drums, bass, the vocals, of course. Then we come to a bit of a standout song. Some reviews may call this a filler track, but it's absolutely not a filler track. It shows that the band is capable of more than just laying down some metal grooves. Undercoat, clocks under 3 minutes, is a really beautiful melody. It's an instrumental song, and it's really gentle, it's really fantastic, and it gives you a moment of rest. And the rest continues, because the next song, Swimming Through Deserts, is absolutely my favorite track of the album, because there's hardly any metal in it, but a really fantastic progressive song with great vocals, with again beautiful melodies and well played by the band. And then the final track, Shut Eye Wanderer, 16 and a half minutes, where all the elements come together, the metal, the grunts, really fast double bass, you know, heavy drums, fast guitar riffing, fantastic. And listen to that song a lot and you hear more and more textures, more and more details in it. And that shows that this band is not just the next prog metal band, but this is a band that knows how to write a good song, a strong song with a lot of details in it, a lot of texture in it. And they have a fantastic groove when you listen to the album. I really enjoy this very much. I'm very happy that they got a chance from Generation Prog Records to have their debut album out. It was mixed and mastered by Mr. Dan Sueno. Now, he does only the finishing touch. The band did the biggest part of the work, the writing and the recording of the music. And they did a fantastic job. An extraordinary album that will definitely give you a lot of enjoyment, a lot of hours to enjoy to listen to it. So I can only say I absolutely highly recommend it. Efflorescens, Coma Ghosts.